Welcome to the biology classes once again. We were studying chapter 9 biomolecules. Okay, so we'll have to study more about enzymes in this class. How enzymes help in the chemical reactions? We have already seen that each enzyme is having a substrate binding site called what? Active site, isn't it? So the enzyme and substrate will substrate will bind to the enzyme in their active site and form an enzyme substrate complex. Understood? This complex is short lived and then it will get disassociated or it will get splitted into products and the unchanged enzyme. Okay, and there is a small intermediate stage known as enzyme product complex. Understood? So this is the this is the way how the enzymes are helpful. Okay, enzymes, how they attain the chemical reaction. Enzyme will have an active site. Okay, and this active site will be, or to the active site substrate will bind and form a enzyme substrate complex, and this is very unstable, so it will get split into enzymes and the unchanged enzyme and the products. Okay, with the intermediate phase of what? Enzyme product complex. Is it clear? The catalytic cycle of an enzyme action can be described like this. First, what happened? The substrate bind to the active site of the enzyme, fitting into the active site. Then the binding of substrate induces the enzyme to alter its shape, fitting more tightly around the substrate. Okay, so the enzyme will undergo certain change in the shape, okay, so that the substrate can be strongly bound. Then next is what? The active site of the enzyme will become close to the substrate. Okay, now in close proximity of the substrate breaks the chemical bonds of the substrate and the new enzyme product complex will be formed. Okay, so in the active site, what happened? Substrates, okay, chemical bonds will get broken, and then what? A transient stage, that is enzyme product complex, will be formed. Then what happened? The enzyme releases the product of the reaction and the enzyme will not undergo any change. Okay, and the free enzyme will be released and it will be ready for holding another substrate. So this is the what the various steps that is happening in the process of enzyme action. Okay, now we are going to study about the factors affecting enzyme activity. Okay, so what are the factors affecting the enzymes activity? The enzymes the ability, okay, to work can get affected by various factors. For example, temperature, pH, change in the substrate concentration, okay, or binding of some other molecules to it. Okay, so all this what can affect the efficiency of enzymes. Okay, so let's see how all this affects. Actually, this these factors can change their tertiary structure. Tertiary structure is very important for their enzymatic action, isn't it? Tertiary structure means what? In the 3D what shape? Okay, in the three-dimensional way, how the polypeptide chain is arranged, that is what? Tertiary structure. So that is only providing what forms, or that provides tertiary structure, provides some pockets or crevices for the substrate to bind, called active site. So any change in these factors can change the tertiary structure of the protein, as most of the enzymes are proteins. Okay, so it will affect the tertiary structure, and thereby what happened? It changes the activity. Okay, their efficiency will get changed. Is it clear? So the various factors that affects the enzymes activity or efficiency is what? Temperature, pH, and I told what? The substrate molecules and the presence of some other chemicals that can bind to the enzymes. Okay, so the enzyme shows its highest activity at a particular temperature and pH, called what? Optimum temperature and optimum pH. What is it? Optimum temperature and optimum pH. Okay. So, if the temperature or pH is above the optimum temperature or pH, then the activity of enzymes will get reduced. Okay. And in the higher temperature or higher pH, what will happen? The enzyme activity will get stopped by the denaturation. Okay, the enzymes will get denatured, and that will result in the destruction of the enzymes, and that will results in the reduce in the rate of the reaction. Understood? So high temperature destroys the enzyme activity because what? Proteins are denatured by heat. Understood? So like this, you can see that it will get what the enzymes activity will be maximum, or it will be maximum at which temperature? Optimum pH and optimum temperature. Okay, optimum pH and optimum temperature is the temperature at which the enzymatic activity is maximum. Is it clear? So as the temperature or pH increases or decreases from the optimum temperature or optimum pH, then the enzyme activity get reduced. Okay, now next to what we have to study is concentration of substances. Okay, so as the substrate concentration increases, so in the initial level, what happens? The velocity of enzymes reactions rises, means the speed increases. Okay, then what happened? The reaction reaches to a maximum velocity known as Vmax, and after that the speed of the or rate of the enzymatic reaction will not increase. Is it clear? So initially, as the amount of substrate increases, the velocity of the reaction also increases and reaches to a Vmax, okay, maximum. After that, it cannot increase. Why? Because then the enzymes molecules will become the limiting factors. Okay, means enzymes will be less. Even though if you simply add substrate molecules, what won't be there? Enzymes won't be there free. Their active sites won't be free. So what will happen? The after that, beyond that particular saturation level, okay, there is no increase in the rate of reaction. Okay, so why this is? Because the enzyme molecules are fewer than the substrate molecules, and after saturation of these molecules, there are no free enzyme molecules to bind with the additional substrate molecules. Okay, so this is how the substrate concentration controls or affects the enzymes activity. Okay, then next is what? Another factor that controls the activity of enzyme is the presence of certain chemicals known as inhibitors. Is it clear? So inhibitors are molecules, okay, which reduces the enzyme activity. Okay, when the binding of the chemical shuts off enzyme activity, okay, when certain chemicals shut off enzymes activity, that process is called inhibition and the chemical is called inhibitor. Okay, so sometimes you can see that the inhibitor will closely resemble to the substrate. Okay, and the substrate and the the substrate and the inhibitor molecule, okay, the substrate and the inhibitor molecule will fight for or compete for the active site of the enzyme. Is it clear? When the inhibitor is closely resembling to the what? To the substrate, what will happen? Both of this I have already explained you. Substrate will go and bind to the active site. Okay, and like this only what the reaction will continue. But here what happens is the inhibitor molecules will resemble this substrate, and the substrate and the inhibitor molecule compete or what, fight for the active site. Okay, and due to its close structural similarity with the substrate, the inhibitor competes with the substrate for the substrate binding site of the enzyme. Okay, so what will happen? The substrate cannot bind, and as a result the enzyme action declines. Okay, so this is happening in where? In competitive inhibition. Okay, so example for this is, see, you can see, that is the inhibition of succinic dihydrogenase. Okay, inhibition of, that is succinic dehydrogenase is an enzyme that works on the substrate what? Substrate succinate. Okay, succinic acid, you can see. Understood? Succinic dehydrogenase acts on where? Succinic acid. But malate is resembling to the substrate succinic acid, and then what happened? There will be a reduction in the rate of this reaction. Actually, the succinic dehydrogenase is acting on what? Succinic acid or succinate. Okay, and due to the resemblance of malonate, okay, malonate, what happens? That malonate will compete with succinic acid for the active site of succinic dehydrogenase. Understood? And this causes what? The reduction of the enzyme. Is it clear? So this kind of competitive inhibitors are useful for us. How you know? Because in certain control of bacterial pathogens, okay, bacteria will have what? Its own metabolic pathway. Okay, so we are giving some medicines. Some medicines contains what? Competitive inhibitors. And so that what happened? Their metabolism cannot take place properly. Understood? So I have already explained that metabolism is having a number of steps, and each step will be controlled by a particular enzyme. Understood? So if that enzyme is not available, or if that enzymatic activity is not taking place properly, what will happen? The organism cannot survive, isn't it? That will result in the stoppage of the metabolic pathway. Understood? So for this purpose, we can use medicines that contains what? Competitive inhibitors. Okay, for the site of certain substrate in the metabolism of bacteria and all, and we can get rid of them. Okay, we can we can use this kind of competitive inhibitors as medicines. Understood? Which will compete with the substrate and reduces their enzymatic activity, and that will result in the killing of the microorganisms. Understood? So this is the advantage. So is it clear? So competitive inhibitors means what? The molecules which resembles the substrate and which will compete for the active site of the enzyme. Understood? For the reaction. Understood? So in this way, they reduce the enzymatic activity. So is it clear to everyone? So this is what we have learned today. That is how the factors, what are the factors affecting enzyme activity and how they are affecting the enzyme activity. Okay, so dear children, for your post midterm exam, you won't be having the post midterm exam, so you will be continuing this what? Classification and nomenclature of enzymes in the next class. Okay, so hope you understood this chapter. As I told, you will have to study this topics along with the after watching the video, you please watch the you study the textbook. Okay, please go through the textbook, then only you will understand, otherwise it will be difficult for you. Okay, so after watching the videos, you go through the textbook. Okay, make some points of your own and write in your copy. Okay, so that it will be easy for you. So we'll meet in the next class. Okay.